I will talk about conversion, quantum conversion through coherent driving permanent impulse system, a work done in the laboratory of quantum photonics and the Institute of Applied Physics in collaboration with colleagues Mrzak, Bardetsky, and Makovey. The presentations will have the following structure. I will talk some words about quantum frequency conversion. I will describe the studied model and the Hessian Hamiltonian. Work about Master equation and the Lucas system and the resulting conclusion. Frequency conversion. Frequency conversion is a whole topic. All of us use high internet through optical fiber. Here we have a conversion between electrical signal and optical one. Also, all the is the FM radio channels that substantially modify the market of radio channel. In the following, we will talk about quantum frequency conversion. When we talk about quantum, we have two signals more correlated than classical one. The first experimental observation of quantum frequency conversion is about three decades ago, and here signal from 1,000 nanometers was converted in optical range. More recently, from microwave to optical, and in review for frequency for conversion was appeared in Optica in August, and the authors identify many schemes that allow some quantum conversion. Intraband quantum conversion, cavity electromechanical conversion, electro-optic conversion, magnon-mediated conversion, and atom-assisted conversion. In most of the cases, we see the hybrid system, and the hybrid system are interesting system because they have a lot of parameters. And we can change one of these and obtain the interesting regime at output. Our system consists from two-level artificial emitter with transition frequency omega zero, based yes, Hamiltonian usual Hamiltonian, where Z is the atom operator. With combinational based in the combinational cavity, here is represented by two mirror, really maybe another resonator, with single mode cavity, with operator given blue color. The atom is pumped by coherent radiation. This coherent radiation has the same about the same frequency as transition frequency. The interaction is semi-classical and is given by the third term on our Hamiltonian. Atom interacts with cavity, and the term we describe this interaction contain an important factor, G, and this G is caused by permanent dipole of each level. If we talk about wet system, the master equation in the absence of any decay and leaking is given by this equation. But if you have some decay processes in real system, we have a master equation that has more terms. Decay process for atom is described by the red terms, and also the blue terms describe the pulses in cavity, in resonator. Okay, if primitive conjugate parts of that equation. Solving this equation after same transformation allow to obtain mean photon number in resonator. And the second correlation function, second order for photon correlation function. Okay, the parameters of interest here we have n is the mean photon number of surrounding thermal view of thermostat. Gamma is the decay rate of atom. K is the decay rate of the leaking rate of cavity. Omega is the cavity frequency, and delta the mismatch, the retuning between laser and the transition frequency of two-level system. What we see here, we have just a moment. We have start of mean photon number about unity, and the increasing of parameter eta. We have increase of this photon number, and in the same case you have for eta more than 21 divided by 4, we have an increase of G20. In this case, we have an increase of photon in cavity with increasing of eta, and but eta is proportional to G, or G is responsible for D11 minus D22. And in this case, you have, if you have different dipole of each level, this increase cause the increase of mean photon number. And you can say that presence of dipole couple the resonator mode and the laser signal that excite atom initial atom. And also we saw that correlation increase or decrease depending of some pumping parameters. But